people treat you and people perceive you the way that you put yourself out to them, to the world, right? You walk into a room, and depending on how you carry yourself, the way you present yourself, that is what you are going to get in return. So it was always about maintaining those clear lines, having respect for myself, having respect in the way I presented myself, the way I represented my clients, making sure that people understood I was there to handle business, everything else. And at the time, that extended itself to the way I looked and the way I dressed and the way I conducted myself. I think now we have much more freedom to dress however we want, but still expect a certain amount of respect, because I am not what I wear. I am not, you know, the way I look. But back then, you had to present a certain image because, again, there weren't the same lines of respectability in terms of the way business is handled, right? Now the Me Too movement, I think pretty much men are afraid to look at us sideways, right? Or even give us a compliment, because it's just a very different day and time right now. But back then, it was a lot more permissible, a lot more loosey-goosey. So you had to make sure that you presented yourself in a certain way so they didn't get it twisted, you know? And so